Lots of topics to talk about today, so let's take Jonathan Corpina on the floor to discuss it all. Jonathan, thank you for coming here on a Tuesday, as always.
Thanks for having me back.
Well, okay, before we go to trade, because it looks like that's kind of taking over the markets right now, let's talk about tax reform as House Republicans are trying to, you know, put that back into the market focus or U.S. focus. Is that going to be as supportive as last time?
I think it should be, right? When it was put in last time, it was towards a time when our economy was looking for some change and looking for some help. I think it was going to take some time for individual Main Street investors and large corporations to get a better understanding of what this new tax reform was going to mean for them, right? Because once everything's put in place, it takes time for it to really unfold. And for Main Street, you want to feel it in your pocket immediately, but that will take some time down the road. So I think with this tax reform and the ideals that are coming forward, I think it will be supportive because we did not see any real major ripple effects from the last tax reform. Nothing tremendously negative. Yes, there are some up and downs, but I think overall it was supportive and has been grasped positively by the American public. So at this point, I think if people were going to decide whether they're going to buy into it or not, I think they're going to support it.
It was mostly positive. Meanwhile, Apple has been having a down month so far in September. Is this a tariff-related story or company-specific?
A little bit of a combination of both, right? From a company specific, they're coming out with a new iPhone product. I don't think the iPhone 10 was received as well as they were hoping for. I am not a iPhone 10 user yet, but I'm going to wait and see what comes out next. So I think from a product point of view, Apple needs to continue to come out with new products, better products. And if they don't deliver on that, I think people will pull back from that. But on a grander scale, yes, tariffs clearly are going to play into the role of Apple and many other technology companies. How they are affected, how that plays out, people are still very uncertain about that, of the effects and how China is really going to play into this. So from there, I think that's why we're seeing pressure on Apple.
Sure. I mean, Apple is going to be one of the most vulnerable companies, as they say. But now that we cover tech, let's go to the technicals. What's the overall technical landscape for the indices right now, Jonathan?
You know, the market continues to trend back and forth, trying to find their top, trying to find its spot. Yes, we had a holiday week last week. Some will debate with the Jewish holidays. It's a holiday week this week. So not a ton of participation. But if you're looking at a chart, on the top side, that 1900 level is clearly a psychological level. Yeah, 2900, excuse me. We did trade above that for a little while, but it couldn't stay above there. So I'm gonna keep that as my top for now. And I think from the support side, 2856 seems to be the right level on the downside. We tried to break through that twice. We eventually got through it. That became our bottom. So I'm going to use those bands for now.
All right, well, thank you so much. So 2900 and 2856, those are the key levels to look out for. Guys, we will see you next Tuesday with Jonathan Corpina, and thank you so much.
Thank you.